When you first log into the TrackR app, you're going to see a blurred map up here. Yours will not be blurred, but mine is, because it will show you the last time and place that it connected to your device. So in my case, you can't see it, but it says connected and it's showing exactly where I'm sitting. Now, if you had left this somewhere, it would show you on this map the last place that it connected to. So you could try and go back to that location to find your item, or you have the mesh network of people who may be also using the TrackR app and have their Bluetooth on and get close enough in proximity to your device that it will pop up a newer location on the map. So down here you see I have two different items. I have wallet, and then if I swipe this way, I have keys. Now, you see how close you are to them doing this kind of Marco Polo thing. So you could see getting closer, getting further. Now, the thing is, and this is where I have a little bit of discrepancy, both of these trackers are sitting right next to me on the table as I'm doing this review. But my keys TrackR is showing that it's further away as opposed to my wallet. And that's been like that since I got these two particular trackers. So not entirely sure. I mean, it's a small problem, quote unquote. So on this page, you click the button. You may hear that off in the distance. You can ring your device. Now, the other thing is, even if your phone is off and in silent mode like mine is currently, if you press the lighted button here on the TrackR, you can ring the phone itself, even if it's in silent mode. So that's kind of good. As you saw, it was a little tricky pushing that button because it's recessed. So coming across, this is the home of what the TrackR does. This is the app, this is what you're gonna look at. But you do have some options if we come over here. Again, it will have an email address that it's attached to. I have that blurred out. You can turn it into silent mode or non-silent mode. You can come down to accounts and it will give you like a brief overview of things that have happened. So here you have number of times you've rung the device. So that's the TrackR talking to the phone. Number of times your phone rang the device. You could see I was testing stuff around. Here you have number of separation alerts. Now, there are two different types of separation alerts. There's one where if you lose connection via Bluetooth with the TrackR itself will ring. Or there is the number, if your Bluetooth is lost, the phone pops up with a message saying, hey, you've walked out of proximity of your TrackR. If you have both of them on, it can be a little annoying. I suggest one or the other. Personally, probably would go with the messages on the phone, but you can do that. You could say I only did that once because while I was testing it, I noticed one very large discrepancy in that, and that is if you are pairing your Bluetooth on your phone to another device, the TrackR will set off a message. So every time I would pair it with a Bluetooth headset, it would ring and send me a message. So a little iffy on that usefulness in my case. I just want to be able to ring either item, either the phone or the device or the item that the TrackR is hooked up to. Now, some people may find that useful. I personally do not. You could also see here number of times I helped somebody. So apparently I was close enough to a device that somebody said they lost, because this was not me doing testing, because I do not have a separate phone with another TrackR on it that I could lose and then try and find. Groups, if you have a single item that is attached to multiple people, this is how you would do it. You would add a group, you'd give the group a name, you'd say what device it is that you want as part of this group, and then you attach the people's emails of that group. Now, keep in mind, they do need to have a TrackR account in order to be part of a group. And last option here is sign out. Coming back here, we have Wi-Fi safe zone. So what this will allow you to do is select all the Wi-Fis that are currently on your phone and say, do not give me separation alerts if I'm on this Wi-Fi. Very useful if you happen to walk away or out of distance from your device while you're on your home network. You don't want that constantly going off if your cell phone's downstairs and your keys are upstairs in your room. You can also use Nest with this particular TrackR thing to give you, if I'm this close to home, you know, turn the Nest up. I do not have a Nest, so I was not able to test that out. You also have a quick FAQ, as well as if you want to order more devices. Now, if we use the other hamburger button on the side here, this will be for the trackers themselves. So this will give you options just for them. So I'm going to do my keys, and you can change the name. It will show you the battery level, and here are the two separation alerts. The first is the device separation alert, so that means it will ring the TrackR itself if you get out of range. The other is the phone separation alert, which will put a message on your phone saying, hey, you're out of range. You also have alarm length, you have the type of sound, as well as here you can see the firmware version of the particular item. You can also share from here, and this would be adding a new group.